Hi everyone, this is Rachna and you're watching the Tuesday Nutrition Nugget by The Good Tiffin. Last week we talked about glycemic index, how it affects our blood sugar levels, different foods with high and low GI, and how to balance meals with different GIs. Today we are going to discuss what is glycemic load and how this is a more useful tool for diabetics and people who are watching their weight. How a food affects your blood sugar levels will depend on the nature of the food, that is your GI, and the quantity of carbohydrate present in that food per serving. Glycemic load takes into consideration both these factors and is calculated by multiplying glycemic index into the amount of carbohydrate present per serving divided by 100. So for example, apple has a GI of 39. A 120 gram of apple has around 16 grams of carbohydrate. So the glycemic load of an apple will be equal to 39, which is the GI, into 16, which is the amount of carbohydrate per serving, divided by 100, which gives us the value of 6. So it's a low GI as well as low GL fruit. 0 to 10 is low GL foods. 11 to 19 is moderate GL foods. And 20 and above is high GL foods. So the amount of food, the amount of carbohydrate present in that food and GI, all these three things will matter when we are deciding whether a particular food should be there on our plate or not, especially for a diabetic. So let's look at some of the low, high and moderate GL foods. I've also listed them down in the description box below. Low GL foods. Most fruits like apples, oranges, grapes, grapefruit, watermelon, etc. Non-starchy and leafy vegetables. Millets like your foxtail millets, little millets, barnyard millets, whole and skim milk, beans, most nuts and seeds. Moderate GL foods. Black-eyed beans, that is your lobia, navy beans, oatmeal, muesli, quinoa, brown rice, wheat chapati. Then whole grain spaghetti, depending on how much you eat, how long you cook it, with what you eat it, it can be either low or moderate GL food. Fruit juices, unlike fruits which are mostly low GL, fruit juices are moderate GL. Sweet potato, unlike potatoes, sweet potatoes are moderate GL because they have lots of fiber. High GL foods. Your white bread, white rice, white bagel, white spaghetti are all high GL foods. Potatoes are high GL. Foods like potato chips, chocolate bars, etc. can be moderate to high GL foods. But they're generally not so great for your health, so to be avoided. Now that we've considered different ranges of GL, let's look at some other factors. Preparation. How you cook something, for how long you cook it, can affect its GI, as we have seen in the last week's video, and will consequently affect the GL. Ripeness of a fruit can affect a GI. A very overripe banana will have a higher GI compared to a just ripe banana, and consequently this will affect the GL of a banana. Food combinations also matter. Combining a high GI food with a low GI food can help us bring down the overall GI and the overall GL. We have seen this in the case of Rajgira in our last video. So all these factors will give us a better idea of how a particular food is good or bad for our blood sugar levels. So sure, both glycemic index and glycemic load are excellent tools that can guide us towards healthy meal planning. But alone, they are not sufficient. For example, two foods with similar high GI can be very different. One can be just junk food and another can be a very nutritious food rich in different minerals, vitamins, etc. as we have seen in the case of Rajgira and Ragi. Therefore, a more holistic approach is required to use both these tools and work towards a healthy lifestyle. Hope these two videos will help you put together healthier and tastier meals. This Friday, we are doing a delicious recipe which is an excellent example of how to balance foods of different GIs. So tune in this Friday for an awesome recipe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.